Things have gotten very dull and slow.
Here's a darn good way to make 'em go. Only Coca-Cola gives you that refreshing new feeling. Refreshing new feeling. Only Coca-Cola gives you that refreshing new feeling. Get that feeling with the Coca-Cola.
May 8, 1886, John Pemberton, who created Coca-Cola, took his first serving to Jacob's Pharmacy, where he mixed carbonated water and a little bit of Coca-Cola syrup, stirred it up, and handed it to the first guest. What set Coca-Cola apart from the very beginning was its taste. In America, we love carbonated water. It's an unusual thing. Europeans love their coffee, Asians love their tea, Americans love carbonated water. And they would mix flavors together like sarsaparilla, root beer, lemon, lime, cream soda. So Coca-Cola is just one more of those flavors, but it has this really distinctive, unique taste, unlike anything else. So because of that taste and because of great marketing, Coca-Cola spread across America. The drink is invented by John Pemberton, but John Pemberton was in poor health even when he invented Coca-Cola and actually died 18 months after inventing the drink. Thankfully for the world, Asa Candler was a remarkable businessman who bought the company from John Pemberton. He invented the sample coupon, so when you get a free sample in the mail, you can thank Asa Candler and the Coca-Cola Company. Candler knew if you tried it once, you'd come back and drink it a second time because it tasted so good. He was a marketing and merchandising genius who took Coca-Cola from selling 9 drinks a day in Atlanta, Georgia in 1886. By 1900, were sold in every state of the U.S., plus Cuba and Canada and Mexico. And if you take yourself back to 1886, that was the year the Transcontinental Railway was finished. The world was a different place. You had to go stagecoach. But suddenly this little company from Atlanta, Georgia becomes a nationwide force. In 1899, Asa Candler either created the greatest business blunder or the greatest business decision ever made. He sold the bottling rights for Coca-Cola for $1 to a couple of lawyers from Chattanooga. So by giving away essentially the rights to bottle Coca-Cola, he actually opened the door for franchises and for people across America to say, I want a bottle of Coca-Cola. So in 1906, we opened up bottling operations in Canada, Cuba, and Panama, of all places. Panama because the canal was being built and the workers were getting thirsty and wanted their Coca-Cola. By 1920, there's 1,200 bottlers of Coca-Cola across America. It's just phenomenal growth. And by 1927, Coca-Cola in the bottle is actually outselling Coca-Cola at the soda fountain. By 1950, Coca-Cola is a truly global company, to the point that Time magazine actually put the Coca-Cola company on its cover, signifying that it was the first company that was global. Today, we're sold in more than 200 countries around the world, and every place that you go, except for North Korea and Cuba, you can get a Coca-Cola. What's interesting is 30% of the people that are here in Atlanta working at Coca-Cola support our global operations. So you might have somebody sitting here in Atlanta who's supporting operations in South Africa or Latin America. It's just an amazing company and truly the only worldwide company there is.